Jason Whitlock used to work over at ESPN. Now he's at Fox Sports One. He thinks a lot about the broader implications of sports, and he joins us tonight. So, Jason, it just dawns on me, not a sports expert, but this channel, maybe other sports channels, seem to feel like they have a big part in shaping the culture. Their job isn't just to bring you sports, but it's to make America better. And that they may be biting off more than any sports network can chew, maybe.
They're biting off way more than they can chew. They're not equipped intellectually. They haven't put in the time. They're way out over their skis. But yeah. Again, Tucker, you and I have been having this conversation for a couple of months, and I just want, people are at home mostly laughing about this story, but I actually think it's kind of serious because it illustrates Silicon Valley's influence over the American media. This is a Twitter-driven story. ESPN basically acknowledged we were worried about the Twitter reaction. Were we far enough left on this position to be protected from a Twitter backlash? That's what drove them to make this decision. How much farther left can we move so that Twitter won't kill us? Executives, not just at ESPN, but most acutely at ESPN, are making decisions based off of what type of reaction we'll get from Twitter. And Twitter is rigged by Silicon Valley to be far left. That's the only opinion that's tolerated there. And that's how these decisions happen.
I think that's really, really wise. No, but I've taken Twitter off all my devices. I know I'm not supposed to admit that, but I have, because I don't think you can make clear decisions when you hear the howling of the mob in the background. You can't.
The other thing that John Skipper said there, and I know John Skipper quite well, and I have a lot of respect for him,
yes.
But this is the other funny thing that's going on at ESPN. He basically said, we wanted to avoid the distraction of Robert Lee, and we didn't want to create a distraction. If you look at ESPN and the sports media's narrative on Colin Kaepernick, when the NFL says, we want to avoid the distraction of Colin Kaepernick, so therefore we don't want to be associated with, they are clobbered and beat up, and how dare you suggest that Colin Kaepernick's any type of distraction? But when it's one of their employees who's a potential distraction, they make the same damn decision as the NFL. That's the hypocrisy. It's just crazy, man, this time we're living in, and the madness that Silicon Valley, through Twitter, through Google, through Facebook, the racial division that they are driving intentionally, and the rest of the American media is so addicted to the Silicon Valley social media that we won't stand up and do the right thing. You can't be honest in this society anymore as a media person, because executives and people running these media corporations live in fear of social media.
You got to write a book on this, and when you do, I hope you'll sell it on this show, like repeatedly, because I think it's a really smart and true thesis, and no one else is saying it. You're right. Jason Whitlock, thank you.
Thank you.